Like so many people, I was drawn to cycads because they're really ancient. They lived alongside the dinosaurs, and we know that dinosaurs ate them because we look at the guts of dinosaurs and we see cycad seeds in them. Cycads are the world's most endangered group. They're more endangered than corals and amphibians. One of the threats is from deforestation and land clearing. Another threat is from poaching. I've been to sites where cycads have been collected before and there are no cycads left. And so it's obvious that these cycads are being poached. I've also been to botanic gardens where they're forced to keep cycads behind locked gates. There's also been stories of plants being dynamited out of rock in national parks. And these are really rare and old historic plants. The problem with poaching is that cycads grow really slowly. It takes 1 year for the seed to produce its first root. And then next year, it finally produces a first leaf. So that's a really long time. So if you think of taking a plant from the wild, the other plants really can't survive and reproduce that quickly to replenish those plants. The other thing is that cycads are really rare, and so by taking one plant in particular, then it has a huge impact on the rest of the population. You can buy the sago palm at nurseries. The sago palm is actually a cycad, so they're pretty easy to find. The other rarer species are a little bit more expensive. They can be $50 to $100 to several hundred dollars, depending how old they are. And stolen cycads can go for as much as thousands of dollars. So there was a bust a while ago where 500 plants were stolen. And if you think of cycads, there are very few plants left in the wild. So stealing 500 plants is going to have a huge impact on cycad conservation. And the thing with cycads is that once they're gone, they're completely gone. There are a lot of international regulations governing the trade of cycads. And there are also rules where growers have to produce documentation to show where they obtained the cycads from. And so all of these measures are put in place to stop people trading cycads illegally. There's also people who have started using microchips. They embed that in the trunk of cycads so that they can actually trace if cycads have been stolen. Here at Cal Academy, I'm going to be leveraging science to help conserve cycads. And the way that I'm doing this is through DNA. Sometimes cycads are moved from one region to another. And we want to look at the genetics of that to make sure that that is the right thing to be doing for each of these species. Cycads have been around since dinosaurs were on this earth, millions and millions of years. And they're becoming extinct because of what we've done. It's through land clearing and poaching. And so it's up to us to save them. And if you look at a cycad, they're large and immovable. They're noble plants and they look like they've stood the test of time. It would be a huge tragedy for us to lose these living fossils.